All I did was kick him and pull on him.
Yeehaw.
Attentive.
So watch a little bit on the steering, right? So like don't, I mean, I know there's no walls in here, but there should be invisible walls. Keep him a little in off the rail, rein shorter. I want you to keep his pole up, even if it's a little above the bit. Yep, and canter. That's why it needs to be attached. Rein shorter, head higher. That's already a little better though, compression wise. Yeah, head up on this part, higher. Don't be bashful. And if, like, half the thing is, he has to become drivable. The roundness comes from your driving leg, right? That's what I was getting at a bit about. I don't care if he's on a bit or not at first, I just need a pop. Yeah, I have to be able to drive. So, like, right now, let's say in there was people like, I don't love that because it was up. Could you drive the leg now? Could you give him a little tap without going anywhere, right? Not eating, but could you envision going, can I slip him under? Or if I would have put my driving hand on, does he lean down and lay in my hand? Or does he accelerate forward? Does that make sense? We don't want any of those.
So if he accelerates or he leans down or he pulls against you, that's not drivable. That's not shapeable from behind. So he's not really in the right balance to, or doesn't understand the animal well enough to have the discussion of the roundness, right? Walk again, rein shorter. Be careful. Yeah, careful. Rein short, meaning just don't let him dive, don't let him get behind you. Canter. And what I want you really thinking is, in a way, get him off your hand, but really ride the hind legs under his body. There you go. Good, good. Up higher still. Still just cheating a bit on his part. Don't let him go medium. He's starting to get galloping. You, like, I have to kind of push on him a bit now, and then you get him in front of my leg. That's its own thing. That's fine. Just as general, though, don't get him galloping. Higher still in the frame. A little bump out. Do whatever you need with your hand. Get his head up. Yeah, up and lighten up and tap at his hind legs. So I, can I ride his hind legs under his belly? Yeah. Good, good, better walk again. Watch, so yeah, rein shorter, and that I do the meter. Yeah, that wasn't really walking, though. Meter. Yeah, short reins, head up. Yeah, that's better compressed, you got it. There is nicely round, or plenty round, as far as I'm concerned. He doesn't need to be any rounder than that, right? That's more than enough arc and roundness in the top line. He needs to still come up in the frame and back further behind. Oh, my girlfriend's here. She didn't even notice. She's too busy.
I know what you're talking about.
Anna. Yeah. Up, come on, beast. Yeah, good, good. Think of up, back, swing them under. So up, back, rotate. Up, back, rotate. Ah, watch the tempo though. Right leg here, but he's getting too slow. So he won't have any carrying power now. He's low in front again. Up, half out back, tap him under. Lighten up if you can. So you're kind of like a ratchet, clicking him back onto his hind legs. One little, that's it, tap. Nice, there you go, good, good. That's your balance, and a walk, nice. Good, breathe in a second. That was better than that.